Hi, let's talk about the renal vasculature. The renal arteries, which we can see the left renal artery here, as well as an accessory left renal artery there, which would be a hilar accessory renal artery because it's going into the hilum, are branches of the abdominal part of the descending aorta, or just the abdominal aorta, which I am outlining for us here. We can see that before the renal arteries come off of the abdominal aorta, the superior mesenteric artery, which is the blood supply for the midgut, comes off of the abdominal aorta in an anterior direction. The renal arteries are going to ramify or branch into segmental arteries. There are 5 renal segments, so there are typically 5 segmental arteries. These are end arteries, so there we see a segmental artery. There we see a segmental artery. There's another segmental artery. Here's another segmental artery. Those segmental arteries are going to ramify into interlobar arteries. Interlobar arteries can be found within the renal sinus, but as they are transmitted within the parenchyma, they'll be found between the pyramids and the renal columns, so between the cortex and the medulla. So here we can see an example. There's an interlobar artery, and it's moving up alongside of the pyramid, and as it rounds the corner to transitioning between the pyramid and the renal column and the pyramid and the cortical arch, it becomes the arcuate arteries. The arcuate arteries are grossly visible, but they can be very difficult to see unless you have the dissection just right. So I can see an example of an arcuate artery there. There's another one there. Most likely one there, although that could be an arcuate vein. It's difficult to differentiate from a gross level if they're transversely cut like that, especially at this resolution. So the renal veins, let me transition to blue here. The renal veins, and this is the left renal vein, are going to drain into the inferior vena cava. So here is the IVC, and there is the right renal vein. Here is the left renal vein. That inferior vena cava will be conducted up to the right atrium of the heart. So the left renal vein is much longer than the right renal vein, and that is due to the association of the inferior vena cava with the abdominal part of the descending aorta. So the abdominal aorta is on the right side, whereas the inferior vena cava is on the left side. These are lying just anterior to the bodies of the vertebrae. And we can see, therefore, that the left renal vein is much longer. We can therefore deduce that the right renal artery is going to be much longer. It happens to travel, I'll just draw this in here, posterior to the inferior vena cava and right renal artery on its way over. So there's asymmetry of length there. There's also asymmetry of the tributaries that are draining various viscera. So For instance, on the left side, I can see here a common trunk that is going to consist of a left inferior phrenic vein. So left inferior phrenic vein. This is going to drain the abdominal or the inferior surface of the diaphragm on the left side, as well as a left suprarenal vein. So these two are coming together. This is draining the blood from the suprarenal gland into the left renal vein. I can also see a left gonadal vein draining into the left renal vein. All of these branches on the right side, so the right inferior phrenic, the right suprarenal vein, and the right gonadal veins, all drain directly into the inferior vena cava. And what this is doing is setting the stage for left renal vein entrapment syndrome. So what happens is blood returning from these sources, especially from that left kidney, can be occluded at the crux between the superior mesenteric artery and the abdominal aorta. So here we can see the SMA here. There's the abdominal aorta. In profile, it might look like this. With the SMA and abdominal aorta, and the left renal vein running there. So if there's an aneurysm, an abdominal aortic aneurysm there, that is, I should do this in red, but the pen is not cooperating. There we go. There's an abdominal aortic aneurysm there that can really pinch the left renal vein as it sits between the abdominal aorta and the superior mesenteric artery. And so this is the basis behind left renal vein entrapment syndrome. So we've discussed the blood supply to and partially through the kidneys, as well as talked about the higher level return of blood from the kidneys and associated viscera to the inferior vena cava, with a particular emphasis on left renal vein entrapment syndrome. Thank you for your time.